Hi, I'm Sierra. I am chairman of SLAB.
Hi, I'm Judson. I'm vice chairman of SLAB.
Hi, I'm Annie. I'm the secretary of SLAB.
A brief explanation on what SLAB is. SLAB stands for the Student Leadership Activities Board, and we're basically in charge of all of the activities that we have here at school. So we put on this talent show for you guys.
Thanks everyone for coming to this talent show. We're glad everyone's able to make it to this YouTube live link. And obviously we're having this event virtually because of COVID. And we usually have a traditional talent show every year, but of course we're not able to do that. But we're still glad we're able to have this activity and virtually. And we hope that we're able to plan a few more activities before the end of the year, even though we have COVID going around. So look forward to that, and thanks for watching the show.
We all hope that you had a really good break. Hopefully you were all safe and did legal things. And I hope that this year is better than the last year.
My name is Jeremiah Anderson, and I'm a junior this year. I'm a member of SLAB who helped organize this event, and
Hi, my name is Kyler Tompkinson. I'm in 10th grade. I am in 2021, and one unique thing about myself is I have two middle names, John and Blaze.
What's up, guys? My name is Madeline B. I am a senior at InTech, and I am part of SLAB. Something I consider unique about myself is that I love singing. So I want to say thank you to everyone who's participating in the talent show, wish you good luck, and a Merry Christmas.
Hi, I'm Yasmina Squizade. I'm a sophomore at InTech. I'm Leadership Principles 2, and one unique thing about me is that I'm bilingual.
Hi, my name is Sydney. I'm a junior. I'm in OP2, and one unique thing about me is that I'm bilingual.
Hi, I'm Maddie Law. I am a sophomore. I am in Leadership Principles 2, and one unique thing about me is that I love to read.
Hi, my name is Eliza Bailey. I am in the 10th grade here at InTech, and I am a member of the Leadership and Principles 2 class. And all of you know him already, probably. But here's Whiskey, here to say hello and to wish you a very happy holiday.
Thank you. my name is Emily Humphreys. I'm 10th grade. This is my second year at InTech. I am in LP2. Thanks for watching. The next act will be up shortly.
Thank you. Reagan Choir. I'm in 10th grade. I'm in SLAB, and a special talent of mine is I can do the splits. Up next.
You can hold my hand if no one's home. Do you like it when I'm away? If I wouldn't hurt my body, baby, would you love me the same? I can feel all my thoughts coming back and I'm craving motion. Mama never really learned how to live by herself. It's her curse and it's growing. You're a pond and I'm an ocean. Now what do my emotions feel like? Explosions when you are around. And I found a way to kill the sound. Ooh, baby, I am a wreck when I'm without you. I need you here to stay. I broke all my bones that day I found you. Crying at the lake, was it something I said to make you feel like you're a burden? Oh, winds, if I could take it all back, I swear that I would pull you from the tide. Oh, 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 darling, when I'm fast asleep, seeing this person watching me, saying, is it worth it? Is it worth it? Tell me, is it worth that? Oh, oh. First there is something and there is nothing. There is nothing in between. Dim my eyes, there is a tiny dancer watching over me, singing, she's a lady, and I am just a boy, singing, she's a lady, and I am just a line without a hook.
Hey guys, I'm Ben, I'm in 7th grade, and I'm going to be building Baby Yoda in Minecraft for my talent show project. here is Baby Yoda, and hope you enjoy.
As there are normally two talent shows a school year, and this year there's only been one, I figured, you know, senior year, do a large magic trick, do two in one talent show, you know, break the system a little bit. So, hint, hint, SLAB, do another one. I'll do an even better one then. So what I decided to do is I do a more of a beginner style magic trick with a deck of cards and showing the progression from there to the then advanced magic trick, which is more mentalism and in your head type of thing. All right, so without further ado, here is the beginner's magic trick. So what I have here is a beginner's deck. All right, you know, you hole punch the entire deck in the same spot, and then you get a hole straight through the deck that you can then string a shoelace through. If you're dumb enough like I am, you do this to then avoid dropping your cards or spilling them on the floor, and then they get ruined and stained or bent. You have to go get another deck of cards to hole punch and ruin. All right, so enough about that. Let's show you a bit about the cards. The cards are all hole punched, as you can see here. They're all different cards as well. All right, and as you can see here, you can see right through the deck of cards. All right, now, if you were here in person, I would have you, you know, tap a card, I pull it out, reveal it, I'll see this one, so we'll do another one. All right, there's your card, okay? And then we'll do one more. I'm not looking at this one, I swear. This one I'll put face down. Okay, all right, so now we have your two cards. And now I'll put these two cards, these two, up in the corner so you don't forget what they are, as I will take them. That's not looking. Still your cards. Okay. Take them, shove them into the deck of cards, shuffle it up, give it a mix. And as you can see here, I have no break, I have no pinky holds, nothing of the sorts. Okay. As you see, I'll just take my hands off for a minute. So what this achieves is your cards, two of them, one of which I know, one of which I do not. Or one of which I do know, one of which I do not. And this allows me to then find your cards in a spectacular way. What we didn't show was the rope. All right, so this rope, as you can see, pretty normal. It's just a shoelace, guys. I just went out and bought a shoelace. So I got two new shoelaces, and this is one of them. So it's not that bad, guys. So what we'll do is I'll go ahead, feed this into the deck of cards. It is quite a feat, let me tell you. Very punny. Very punny indeed. All right. So now you end up with this deck of cards back on the shoelace. Yay! I know y'all are so happy. So proud of me for doing this. All right, now, if I were here, I'd have someone tie a big greasy knot. I'll go ahead and do one for you. Big old nasty knot. Sometimes it's not kind of come undone quickly. All right, so now what I'll do is, as this is not come undone quick, I figured I would give you a bit of a ripping experience, okay? A bit of a gripper. So what I'll do is you'll count with me wherever you are on a one and a two and a three. See, and now that has come off the deck of cards. But now if you look, two cards, that's all there is here. Two cards, your two cards. Well, I hope so, I didn't see the other one. Your two cards pulled off of that. Not only that, I'll leave these in view, not only that, but the holes from the deck of cards have been yanked off as well. They are no longer holy cards. All right, and there you go. That is the beginner magic trick. All right, welcome to the second of my two talents for the night. The first one being the card trick, being a bit more beginner, kind of intermediate than this one. This one being mentalism, which is quite a bit more advanced. All right, so if you have not already noted, you
there is the chessboard right here that we have drawn. This chessboard, my sister will pick any of the squares at random. Doesn't matter which one she picks. Nothing has been pre-chosen or anything to that effect. Once she has chosen one of these squares, I will be taking a knight, which is the horse piece in the chess set, and I will be moving from that square to every single square on the board, and then without stepping on any of them twice. So for those of you who don't know, the knight, if it were to be here in the corner at A1, it's one move for it, and moving up here to B3 in this L shape, which can be, of course, rotated. So if you were up here, you can move down here. All right, to that effect. All right, my sister here has a blindfold. There's nothing on the blindfold. As you can see, it is see-through. Let's bring that down so I can't see.
Can you see?
Nope.
All right.
And there's, for those of you, there's nothing on my hand. I'm just...
There's nothing on the wall?
Yep.
All right, F5.
Right in the smack dab in the middle. Well, pretty close to it. The first move is always much harder than the other ones. We'll go E7. D5, F4, and then back to E2, C3, A4, C5. D3, E1, G2, H4, G6, H8, F7, H6, G8, F6, E8, G7, H5, G3, H1, F2, H3, G1, F3, H2, F1, D2, B1, A3, C2, A1, B3, C1, A2, B4, A6, B8, C6, A7, C8, B6, A8,
C7, E6, D8, B7, A5, C4, B2, D1, E3, G4, E5. Ooh, getting close. Got what? 8 left? Yep, 8 left. D7. F8. H7. G5. E4. D6. B5, and for the final one, D4. Did that do it?
Yeah, you did it. Number repeated.
All right, thank you guys for watching. That is the final one, unless there is another talent show sometime this trimester or next trimester. Hint, hint to SLAB right there. Farewell.
Signing off as the last MC of the day. Remember, wear a mask, socially distance, and wash hands often to remain as safe as possible. I hope we all have a great 2021. See you guys.